We are just about to start period number three. For those of you just joining us, perfect timing here tonight. It's a 3-1 hockey game. Pittsburgh's got the puck against the boards. Tries to feed it over to Jarvis. Oh, a good textbook hit there. The Penguins pick up steam and are on the attack. Pushes it across to Slavin. The Hurricanes will play it in their own end. Gaining steam here on the attack. Too much congestion blocks the shot. Great timing to come up with the interception. Takes the puck.
He knows he's only one goal away from his next milestone. That's why he's possessing the puck tonight.
And look at scores! And with authority at that.
Tom Cheddar, I mean, that one goes off the bar and in. That was an unbelievable release. A big defensive breakdown leads to this opportunity, and he makes the most of it with a teed-up shot. It's a one-timer, and he hammers it home.
Carolina's added yet another one here to the total tonight. What a performance.
Yeah, they've had the puck on their stick for a majority of this game. You know the coaching staff is going to be impressed. Hey, maybe they'll get the day off tomorrow.
And off the draw, they take the puck. Quick possession along the wall. Passes it over. The Hurricanes have it against the wall. Takes the feed. And down he goes as the puck goes free. And he maintains possession of the puck here. The Hurricanes move the puck in the defensive zone. There's a shot. Oh, what a stop by Kochetkov.
Great positioning by the goaltender to redirect it to the corner, getting it out of danger.
Big time stop there. Jostled off the puck. The Hurricanes gain possession along the wall. Slides it quickly to Teravainen. The Penguins get a hold of the puck in their own end. Slides it over with pace to Bear. And that's deflected off someone in front. Puck scooped up by Joseph. Oh, they telegraph the pass and he picks it off. The Hurricanes gain control of the puck against the wall. Kotkaniemi's got it deep in the offensive end. Oh, smart heads up play to poke that one away. Quick feed to Bastion. And that's just out of reach. From center, they get into the attacking area. And that shot goes nowhere as the lane was filled. Carolina's been way more active here tonight on the ice, and they have certainly capitalized on their opportunities and continue to lead in the third. Puck grab by Murphy. Pittsburgh's in on the offensive attack now. Moves it to Drury. And the puck skips out of the zone. They'll have to regroup. Murphy's got it along the wing. Quick pass to McGinn. Scooped up along the wall by Nosen. Dumps it into the O-zone. Pittsburgh's got the puck along the wall. Murphy's got it in the defensive end. Nice feed from the left side up the middle. Hooked away as he went all in on that one. There's the whistle as the puck stopper elects to hang on. Getting closer to the halfway point of this frame. Carolina's been the better team, and the scoreboard shows it. 4-1 is where we sit. Slavin's moving the puck through his own zone. Moves it quickly over to Jarvis. Here's the chance. Let's get the call.
I always hated to play in these games. It just came out flat. Nothing you did made it better. Now they got to kill off a penalty when they're getting blown out. Real tough game.
Carolina sending their power play unit out for the first time tonight.
Well, they've earned their first power play of the game. A tone setter right here and an opportunity to look at the coverage on the setup.
And the goaltender grabs that one for a whistle to try to slow things down here. They'll get set to drop the puck as this power play continues. win the draw here at their own end. Gaining momentum along the wing. Takes the puck at the point. And the play continues.
Dismiss that chance.
Goaltender covers it up. We get a whistle to slow things down. Winnipeg's on the schedule next, and tickets still available for this one, so get them before they're gone. Bastion's gliding in for the faceoff as this penalty kill will continue. Kotkaniemi, he's got it into offensive territory. Just wide. The Penguins get a hold of the puck along the boards. Puts it in deep. Looks to get the puck over to Kotkaniemi. Niederreiter's got it through center. Pittsburgh's going to be able to kill a few seconds off now with the puck. They'll want to clear the zone here while they're trying to kill off this penalty. Carolina's got possession of the puck. Well, if they're going to do something with this man advantage, now's the time.
They don't have the luxury of time, James. They have to be urgent and get the puck up ice.
Stalls him in front.
Oh, what a save there, James. I mean, that situational awareness at its finest, knowing exactly where the threat is in that slow slot and taking all the space away.
The Penguins are in transition. Takes the pass on the left wing. Here's a chance. Oh, what a stop with the glove by Kochetkov.
What a fantastic save from a high-danger scoring area, James. And, I mean, he's bailing his team out. They have to do a better job of protecting the middle of the ice.
Carolina's dominated in the puck possession department, putting plenty of shots on net, and they lead by a wide gap in the third. Here's a short pass to Faber. Fantastic save! And some good footwork to kick it away. Puck set across the blue line. And a great save! There's the whistle. We get a face-off after the goalie covers up. The Hurricanes have been the aggressor offensively tonight as they continue to lead in the third. Off the face-off, they take the puck. Battle ensues for that loose puck around the boards. And that's broken up with a stick in front. There's the whistle as the goalie hangs on. More than half the period has gone by. Hope you're enjoying this one. 4-1 is where we sit. A pretty one-sided affair. And now it's grabbed by Slavin. Inside as Arnan moves the puck. Pittsburgh's got a hold of it along the wall. Quick feed to Johnson. And he loses both the puck and his balance after that hit. Nosen's got it in the offensive zone. And that goes off course off a body. Shuts it down.
Gary's dialed in and outstanding at anticipating the play here, James. He recognizes exactly where the greatest threat is on the ice. It's a slot area. He gets the position to make the save.
Taken along the wall by Pesci. Steps inside the line. Puck picked up by Martin. Keeps a hold of it on the play. With the stop. The Hurricanes have it behind the cage. Here's a chance. They score! Four straight goals. They're rolling now.
And talk about confidence, hey, James. I mean, their opponent does not have an answer. They look absolutely stunned. I mean, they are like a freight train just pounding down on them. Well, this is an incredibly intelligent shot, James. It's recognized that there's net front presence in front of the goaltender who's dropping to a butterfly to try and take away as much net as possible, and it finds its way through.
Carolina's offense continues to shine here in this third period.
Well, this has got to be a dream for a coach. You know that they're telling their team in the intermission to make sure they stay to business, stay to task, stay focused. And that's exactly what they've done, and they just hammered their opponent.
Martinet's got the puck. With the blast! Off target! Battle along the wall. And they'll go on the attack. Great pressure by Kotkaniemi. And a strong effort on that play. Fires it into the offensive zone. Moves it to Bortuzzo. Gets the puck over to Joseph. Taken by Spacek. Forces the turnover. And now he moves it to Glass. Shot! Makes the save of the slapper! Kick pass to Joseph. The Hurricanes take it along the wing. Angles it over to Bortuzzo.
Huge steal at his own end. Takes a shot and turns aside the slapper with ease.
Moves it over to Natchez.
Dishes it off. And the traffic neutralizes that threat. A chance to get it out.
Moves it quickly over to Natchez.
28 seconds to go. Here we go. They've really ratcheted up the intensity here now in the O-zone. They've got numbers here. Brings it off the iron.
Well, he knew what he was going to do coming in one-on-one with the goaltender. Looked real confident in it, but man, he just missed by inches. That one's unlucky. It hits the post and comes out.
Oh, it's some smooth skating to lose the defender there. It is all over.
And you can chalk up another in the L column, and this is the exact opposite of a heater right now, Cheryl.
Yeah, this is a tough one when you're on a losing streak like this. It just is so deflating, James. And although they've had good stretches in games, their game management has not been good. Mistakes that are costly have cost them a lot.
Moments away from puck drop for period number three. A perfect time for those viewers just joining us here tonight. The Jets lead it by one.
Jostling for the puck and he loses control. And they'll battle for that loose puck along the boards. Still keeps a hold of it. To the front! Denies him! Hellebuck's got it, and I think there's a little strategy involved as he opts for the whistle.
Well, yeah, I think he needs a rest, but it's also about game management. Listen, the only reason why they're winning this game is because he has been electric and dynamic between the pipes.
Play resumes here as he wins the draw inside the offensive zone. Gives him nothing in front. The Sharks gain possession. Good stand-up hit. Look at this, 2-on-1. A chance! Makes the save! Low, how did that stay out?
There's a clear strategy going on here, and they're shortening the bench.
I can even figure this one out, James. You don't have to be an analytic genius to figure out who scores the goals on this team. And I'm telling you right now, this is happening because they want to get back in it. They're trailing by one. You've got to manipulate your bench and make it happen.
Winnipeg's got the puck in the defensive end. And he slides it quickly for Perfetti. San Jose's got the puck here in the open ice. Works it across to Kako. Grabs control of it at the point. And there's the save. And the goalie covers up for the whistle. Lots of time left in this period. Winnipeg's up 1-0. Perfetti's won the draw inside his own end. Here's a short pass to Ehlers. The Jets get a hold of the puck in the open ice. Winnipeg's gained possession. Takes a shot, and that goes off the player. And the puck departs the zone. He's in, all alone. Poked away on the breakaway.
What I love about this is there is zero indecision. I mean, he makes the decision, and he fires away with a poke check to make the save.
San Jose's got a hold of it against the wall. Exploring options here inside the defensive zone. Feeds it over. Answers it with an even better save. Slides it across. Oh, sensational stop with the stick by Bobrovsky.
I love this save, James. I mean, the goaltender is so aggressive on this play. Doesn't give the shooter any time to get rid of it.
They go on the attack from the left side. San Jose's got a hold of the puck now. Tenacious battle for the puck along the wall. Unable to reach that one. Grabs the puck here in the neutral zone. The Jets carry it along the wall. Well saved, made by Bobrovsky. And the puck stopper hangs on to get a breather here for the team. Plenty of playing time left in this frame. Winnipeg's ahead 1-0. Off the draw, wins possession. Into the offensive end now. The Jets take possession in the defensive end. Moves around along the half wall. Takes a knock, but he's still got the puck. Slides it on over to Kelly. Great use of the stick here at center ice. Passes on over to Pionk. The Jets will play from the defensive zone. Here they are on the attack. Great reach with the poke check by Carlson. Tosses it on to Couture. Looking to make something happen in the offensive zone. Oh, and somehow he gets a sliver of it and keeps it at bay. Hellebuck's got the puck, and he's going to slow things down.
Well, he's slowing things down because his team has been under siege, James. It's the third period. It's a tight game, and he elects to get the whistle. I like this decision. It's the right one. Now everyone can get a rest, and coach can get the right personnel out there. Got to figure he knows about this next milestone. He's only one goal away.
Passes it over, and that doesn't reach the net. Loose puck battle along the boards. The Jets gain control of the puck. Picked up along the boards by Ekholm. There's a shot, and that's blocked. My goodness, look at this. The pressure is really starting to fall.
The Jets have been extremely strong defensively tonight. They protected the interior of the ice. They pushed everything to the perimeter, and now they're protecting the shutout.
Can't keep a hold of the puck after that play. Across the line. San Jose's got the puck in their own end. Quick feed to Joseph. Oh, great read on the play. Puck sent down the ice. We'll get an icing.
Pionk's trying to find a way to get back to the bench and not put his team in a vulnerable spot. You can see that he's been injured somewhere on the shift. He's laboring and he's wincing, but he's committed to the play. He's got to find the appropriate moment to get off.
More than half the frame has been played here. The Jets lead it 1-0. Perfetti's gained possession, and his great work inside the faceoff circle pays off again. Handles the puck. Great read with a stick. He got all of that one. Quick feed to Brodzinski. The Sharks scoop it up along the boards. Grabbed along the boards by Grundstrom. Moves it to Brodzinski. The Sharks play it along the wing. And we'll play on.
Well, you spend so much time trying to create scoring chances, and when you do, you gotta find the back of the net. At the very least, hit it, James.
In the final moments of this period, we've got a 1-0 hockey game thus far. San Jose's won the draw. Now let's see what they can do with it. Play is whistled dead as the puck goes up and over. A big face-off here inside the offensive end. San Jose's won the face-off. Scores! And look who it is! The young man has done it, his first in the National Hockey League.
And what I love about this moment, James, is that everyone is celebrating with him because you know how important it is and how great it feels to get your first. Always going to tell you after a great game that it's all about the team win, James. But I think he's disappointed here because he could just taste the shutout, and he's had a fantastic game, one that he deserved and possibly earned. Just let that one go through.
Well, where were you moment in that household, because he's got his first ever goal.
And that's going to feel good, and it's a milestone moment, James. No question about it. It's his first ever, and there's only one of those. So you can expect that that puck will be somewhere on his wall, in his house, somewhere.
Good hit to pump him off the puck. Can't keep a hold of it. Reads it. Huge hit against the glass.
I love the physicality in this game, but now there's going to be a stoppage in play, James, as that glass, it is broken.
Lowry's going off for Gordon. Boy, what a chance for the man advantage unit as they take to the ice for the first power play on their side all game.
First power play opportunity for this team. It's going to start in the faceoff circle, getting possession with the win, and then looking to set up.
And they get the puck out of the defensive end. Delandry has got the puck in his own zone. Takes a whack, but still hangs on. Fires it. Oh, and a save with the glove.
Hellebuck's been dominant in the crease tonight. He's turned away a lot of high-danger shots, and he's really found a way to build some momentum for his team, give him a real opportunity to win.
Another face-off looming here on this power play. And with the centers tied up, he swoops in to take possession. Dishes it off. Oh, a lucky break for the shooter as it goes off the inside of the iron and stays out.
Well, the adrenaline's rushing. You're getting yourself to the right spot at the right time with an opportunity to go ahead in the game. And yeah, hit the post and out.
Quick shot. Oh, what a block. He'll get a pat on the back from the coach when he gets off, if he can get off.
Let's see what the officials are calling. Joseph's going to get two for delay of game as he throws the puck over the glass. Huge opportunity for the power play as they'll start with a 5-on-3.
Playing with a two-player advantage on the 5-on-3 is such an opportunity. But you have to have a sense of urgency that goes along with it. You don't want to be static. You do want to force the coverage to have to move a little bit.
And that's intercepted. Picked up along the wall by Wheeler. And he slides it quickly to Dillon. Gets it over to Morrissey. Deep inside the defensive zone, trying to clear the puck. Nice poke check. Lowry's penalty has expired, and he'll join the penalty kill as they remain shorthanded.
Sends it to the middle. Oh, wins the puck. Feeds it over.
And the traffic jam in front blocks the shot. Winnipeg's penalty killers get a hold of it. The Sharks starting to go on the attack. And the save. Oh, here we go. This team knows how to turn it up another gear.
Big face-off coming up here in the offensive zone.
Well, after that last shift with sustained pressure, you know that the goaltender is fatigued. You got to find ways to get pucks to the net.
Under a minute to go here in regulation time. They get it out of the defensive end. Shot! And that goes off a player in front. Quick pass to Miller. The Jets carrying it along the blue line. Puck battle along the boards. Oh, they telegraphed the pass, and he picks it off.
Joseph standing up, ready to go.
That'll do it for the man advantage. Phenomenal penalty kill performance on that one.
Timing is everything, James. A critical moment of the game. You have a power play. You know how important it is, and you don't deliver. Real frustrating for the entire group.
And a solid job tying up his opponent. The Jets look to start the transition game. Moves it quickly over to Scheifele. And it's stopped by the glove. Nice play there. Bobrovsky's got the puck and he's going to hang on. A big draw looming here in the offensive zone. Scheifele's won the faceoff, and now let's see what they can do. Now a quick pass to Dillon. The lane was plugged up and that shot's blocked. San Jose's got it in their own zone. High speed at center, moves up ahead now. Oh, he just gave! Save right at the end! And there's the horn. Regulation solves absolutely nothing. So we're going to overtime, and we'll do it next.
Now's your chance to play clean. Join us at our arena as the first sports and entertainment facility in the entire country. 100% renewable energy. Drop your plastic cups, bottles, and clean paper products in the Play and Clean recycling bins located throughout the arena. Thank you for joining us in the campaign to save energy and keep our city clean.
One will win, one will lose. Overtime will tell the story. And with that, the clock is ticking here on overtime. Let's see if we can get ourselves a hero here. Here's an off-man rush. Here in the corner, he grabs the puck. Oh, how did that stay out? What a save by Bobrovsky. It's a 2-on-1. Into the offensive zone.
Shot! What a save! Oh, my goodness! I thought they had it there off the rush.
The Sharks get a hold of the puck along the boards. Knocked around, but keeps it going. 2-on-1. Here we go. To the crease. Digging in defensively to stop that rush. And makes the save. From the right wing, he moves it to the middle. And that's poked away. Moves with the puck in the corner. And he takes the feed. Barbashev's lugging the puck. And he'll take a moment to regroup back at center. There's the whistle. Let's get the call for the officials.
Well, such a tough penalty to take in overtime when the pressure is on, James. Now they've got to try to survive this and extend the game.
A feed out front. And he shuts down a great scoring chance there.
Corvettes recognizing they're still short-handed here as they get ready for the faceoff. San Jose is going to start with the puck in their own end. And the puck is moved to a safer spot on the ice. Right side set up ahead into the middle of the ice. And the pass is redirected. And they get the puck out. Final minute of OT, and it's still anyone's game. Inside the offensive zone. The Jets have it against the wall. The Sharks have it now. The Jets have it in the offensive end. The Sharks have possession shorthanded. And that's a solid clearing attempt on the play. Winnipeg's looking to break out. Off the left wing and into center. Cutting to the front of the net.
take. Got thoughts in my head, don't need opinions made. 10 green balls out on the wall. And one by one, I'm gonna watch them fall. I get narrow in the ceiling and never sleep. It's my last switch up the jump, never sleep. Liz, I when I come up back in our room town. I don't care much, man, cause I do it in my sleep. Drive my car and this on. I do what I want. The plan was to get to New York, but now that's all just this one for it.
I'll flip that, bruv.
If you wanna call me Sly, call me Ted Bundy, call me Jack Ripper, call me Big Bishop. I'm a poor boy, so I'm always bitter. Watch these shows to a show. I'm smiling when I'm in the city. Got thoughts in my head, opinions made. On the wall, one by one, I'm gonna watch them fall. I'm getting narrow in the ceiling, never sleep. It's my last one, I'm gonna sleep. It's all when I come up, I'm not doing so. I'm gonna get much better, I'm gonna sleep. Cause I'm gonna sleep.
That's me done. I pick up Nasty Jack, man. Legend.
We are just about to start period number three. For those of you just joining us, perfect timing here tonight. The Avalanche have been holding down a 2-1 lead. And a little body contact on that play. Here's a short pass to Trouba. And he takes the pass. Gets the puck in deep. The Avalanche have gained possession off the wall. Colorado's got a hold of the puck. And sends it just out of reach. And now he tries to get it across to Boqvist. And that's picked off in the neutral zone by Terry. And he's knocked off the puck there. Slides the puck over. Quick feed to Terry. And the referee caught that trip on the play. We've got a delayed penalty coming up.
That's certainly not going to help the team. I mean, they're losing by one. They've got to find a way to get some momentum to get on the board. Now they find themselves still in the penalty.
Good job tangling up his opponent here. Trying to clear the puck from his own end. Then they get the puck out and they needed that.
They certainly did. This PK unit has been on fire. They get the clear. That's one. You kill valuable time. That's two. And now three. You can contest the entry. That's a great play all the way around.
Takes a bump but still hangs on to the puck. Nice job to escape the zone. Fires it on net.
Well, this is just a prime example of doing what it takes to keep the puck out of the net. In this case, right off the noggin.
Made that stop.
Well, that was a hard shot, and the mask makes the save. He got his bell rung on that one, James.
Oh, he gets a blocker on it. What a stop by Ronta. From one end of the blue line to the other. And cut that one out of the net. Puck is frozen, and we'll get a face-off. What an opportunity here on the power play with this offensive zone draw.
It's all about motion and puck movement. Make the goaltenders already fatigued move.
McKinnon's won the draw here in the offensive zone. And it's a quick pass to Nichushkin. Just slide to the net.
The real skill to be accurate and have a heavy shot. And right now, it's just a heavy one that misses the ball.
McKinnon's ready for the draw on this man advantage.
Terry's up and ready to get back on the ice.
Solid effort by the penalty-killing unit as the power play comes up empty.
Already down in the game and your back's against the wall. This is a massive kill. You want to keep the game within reach.
And they'll use that dump in to change up the defense. Moves the puck up to Benson.
into the attacking area from the left side. Sends one up to Lombard. Carrying the puck deep inside his own end. McKinnon's going to play it against the half wall. Turn that chance aside. Slides it across. Passes it over. Scores! Nathan McKinnon!
You see players taking the shot all the time in practice with their skill coaches, and I'm telling you right now, this is perfect execution. Shooting in stride, quick snap of the wrist, and putting it in the back of the net. Not to see where you want to be. His head was up the whole time.
Inching closer to the midway mark of the period. Colorado's got a 2-goal lead. They'd love to build on it. McTavish has one possession. Broken up with a stick in the defensive zone.
Moves it to the middle. And that chance is blocked.
Well, and this is in response of a dangerous hit, and now one of your players is injured, James. It's really important that you stand up, you stick up, and you defend in this situation.
Here we go. And scores the takedown, and that'll bring this one to an end.
Yeah, gets his weight over him and takes him down to the ice, and he's going to be the victor in this one. The road team's bench is banging their sticks, standing up as they cheer on their player, and that tilt went their way.
Well, with the chaos cleared, face-off now for both teams. And they take possession after the defensive zone faceoff. Carey stick handling in his own zone.
7 minutes, 22 seconds. Picks up the puck. He scores! Number one on the season!
That's gotta feel good. You know that you're setting yourself up for the rest of the season. You're always gonna get off to a good start, and there's no better way than getting your first goal. Some goalies have cat-like reflexes, and tonight he's just a little slower, James, to get across, and unfortunately it hits him. He doesn't get all of it, and it winds up in the back of the net.
Anaheim's got to be feeling confident now, getting that one back, Cheryl.
And it puts a lot of pressure on the opponent, James. They've held the lead, and they've given up one. Now they're within one goal, which means it's striking distance in the third period. As a defender, you know when they're coming, and they got to win this faceoff and dictate the pace.
Fabry's taking it from his own end. Pass right back. Anaheim's ready to go on the attack. And loses possession after a solid hit. Quick cross ice pass to Barrett. A little crashing and banging forces the turnover. Pokes it away to stay on the attack. The Avs get a hold of the puck in their own end. The Ducks take possession here in the open ice. Poked away by Barron.
The Avs get their second line out there, James. They've been real effective tonight. They've been dominant in the offensive zone. They've been key contributor, and this is really important when you want to get that secondary scoring.
San Jose's coming up next on the schedule, and these two teams, doesn't matter where they are in the schedule, where they are in the standings, always a good contest. I'm looking forward to that one. And there's the little boost from off the wing as the centers were tied up there. The Avalanche have the puck in their own end. Knocked away. Gets a hold of the puck from the right side. Dumps it in. The Avs gain possession. And he sends it across to Coughlin. He carries the puck up along the wing. Still has possession. And that goes off someone in front and doesn't reach the net. Sends it quickly to Henrik. Colorado's gained possession. Moves it to Landeskog. And now they look to make something happen from the neutral zone. The Ducks gain possession along the wall.
Landeskog's pass was so difficult, James. I mean, he stumbled, so he's off balance, and he's still able to corral the puck and get it off with precision to the shooter. That leads to a great scoring chance.
Dishes it off! With the stop. Slides the puck across to Bokas. Quick pass across to Makar. Huge play in his own end to come up with the puck.
Anaheim's been disrupting play all night long, and this is because of their stick positioning. You have to find ways to be aware and anticipate where that puck is going to be going. Doing a great job, but this is still a close one. They've got to find a way to generate some offense.
Colorado's got it, and they're on the attack. Scores! And there's the counterpunch we were looking for. Sure, as they answer back.
Well, they answer back, and they take the lead. North momentum out of their opponent's sails. This is exactly what they needed to get back on the floor and get the momentum shift back in their favor.
Their lead to 2 goals here in the third.
I mean, that's got to feel good. It's been a highly competitive game. Now you've got a 2-goal cushion. You don't want to let any life into your opponents. So you've got to shut the door completely now.
McKinnon's quick stick lands on the puck here at center. Oh, and a misfire as that goes right out of the zone. The Ducks gain possession of the puck here in the offensive end. Drills them. Colorado's got it along the wall. Picks up the feed. Quick pass to Benoit. And that's off a stick. Oh, we got a tripping penalty coming up here. The officials were all over that.
Oh, stopped it. What a save on the play.
And there's nothing technical about that. That is all about the will to find a way to make that save. Incredible, James.
Fabry's getting called for tripping. Work.
Power plays, more time on the ice, the ability to get that puck moving. These players know exactly what they're doing. They work on it in practice, spoke to some of them earlier today at the pregame, and they talked about the execution and the precision in particular with their puck movement.
The Avalanche have the puck against the boards. Colorado's got it in their own zone. Feeds it over.
Well, this save looks easier than it actually is. I mean, when you have a shooter right in the slot and you know that you've got to find a way to get your glove on it, you got to be fast, you got to be quick and show those reflexes. He does that and makes a save.
Was won it off the faceoff. I don't think anybody was hanging on to the puck after that hit. Just misses.
Players work too hard to have the puck on their stick and to get to scoring areas to not hit the net. Even if they don't score, they'll get a rebound if they at least hit the tender.
Oh, look, this last save by Kiffer. Here's a pass in front. Oh, and he couldn't connect on the play. Puck scooped up by McKinnon. Centering in front. And that's stopped. Slides it up to Benson.
10 seconds.
Fabry's almost ready to get back on the ice.
Kemper's opted to hang on to the puck for a faceoff. Here in the late goings of the period, it's 4-2. Puck is dropped and he wins the draw here in the defensive zone. The Ducks penalty killers come up huge.
Although they're still trailing, this game is now within reach. Stop!
And they run back with another.
Now back-to-back goal. You can feel the energy, the wind, momentum, and the tides have turned here, James. They need to keep the pedal to the metal. Well, that goal just ignites a fire down the entire bench, and sometimes it's about the drive and the energy within a shift that can just change the course of an entire game. There's so many ebbs and flows, momentum shifts. This one is one of them.
Still showing no signs of let up here in this third period.
Well, they've had such an impressive performance, James. It's been dominant in all areas of the ice, and there's been no lag or no let up. The message has been clear by the
coaching staff as well as everyone on the bench. Keep pushing.
Right on the doorstep. And that's blocked in traffic. What a steal in his own end. Moves the puck inside the offensive zone. Keeps possession. The Avs played along the boards. 2 seconds. Anaheim's got a hold of it against the wall. And he moves it up to Robertson. And that's knocked away. Tries to get it over to Nichushkin. And he feeds it down to Landeskog. Right up the gut into the offensive end. The Ducks gain possession in their own end. Oh, and he tracks it perfectly in the offensive end. Oh, fantastic save off the post.
Newhook's been effective getting to the right places at the right time, but it hits the post again, James. He cannot score.
Game's here. They're going to have to find a way to reset and get back on track.